Hello all, welcome back to the Guitar Temple. Hello. Hopefully you told a friend. Good. Are you rushing? We don't rush. A lot of people do in this world now. I need it tomorrow morning. No. What you want to do is build a major league, world-class, strong foundation. You build a great foundation. The foundation is strong, okay? You're going to build a good career. What I want you to do, though, is my audition date, mentally you say, is tomorrow. My audition for Shania Twain is tomorrow. It gives you a sense of urgency. But as tomorrow comes, don't just throw your hands up and it didn't come right away, so to hell with it type thing. No, it's a forever swim. It's a marathon, okay? All right. What will 365 days of consistent follow through and push, what will that do for you in your life endeavor, whatever it might be for you? Real estate, motocross, whatever it is for you, you know? High-end wedding photographer. I was a wedding photographer too, in Miami. Oh yes, 2,000 capacity weddings and stuff. All right, so know what your chief aim goal is. Know what you're after, what never goes away in your heart. You've been wanting to be a football radio announcer for your entire life. You would have loved to have done that. You start now. But I'm 51, start now. But I'm 14, start now. Better, believe me, better late than never. Yeah. And whether you get there or not, right? It was the pursuit of happiness. You're pursuing a goal line. There must be a goal line. You're here, you're going there, right? There must be a goal line. So keep going until I win. Half of winning and becoming successful is just merely showing up. Now, there's an audition, but you chickened out. I remember an acting thing that I was gonna do. I'm in Burn Notice. I'm in Rock of Ages. I'm in even commercials with Shaquille O'Neal. I'm in a lot of things like that. But I only went there because my bride wanted to go and be in a commercial, and she chickened out. She did. It was a Sunday, laying there in bed, and says, nah, we don't have to go. I says, you're going. I brought her there, and there was a line of people like you wouldn't believe. From here to that condominium. Guess what? Out of the whole line, did they pick her? No! They picked me. I couldn't believe it. But after I got in there, I picked her. So it worked out for both of us. You see? But had we not gone, had we not shown up, well, remember what I said, stand up. Stand up to the plate, swing as best as you can. You're gonna get knocked down, but you have to get up and keep moving forward. You have to keep going forward. Wipe off your tears. Turn a spaghetti spine into steel. Turn a spaghetti spine into steel. This is what you're looking to do. You have to get up. There's gonna be a lot of pressure. Remember what I told you. The pain brings the pleasure. No sadistic shit. The pain of the discipline, the repetition, and the study. That's all it is. Study, repetition of the study, and an action on the repetition and the study. All right? And then step up to the plate, go for the audition. Go for the job. Well, there's 1,500 people that are going for that. That's right. Go ahead. Like I told you the story, the line was from here to that condominium. They picked me out of the whole line. Okay? And I picked my wife and we ended up doing it together. It was fun. Be a forever person. And everybody in your life will be better off for it. Because you will be going towards who you are. You'll be happier, right? If you're not a mechanic and you know you're supposed to be selling real estate, sell real estate. if you're a real estate guy and you're one of the best mechanics out there, there's no doubt about it, there's getting around it, and you're gonna get paid, half the amount of money, you couldn't be better off doing that, because it's a life journey, right? It's not about buying things and what owns you, you know? It's the spirit of who you really are. I hope you get my meaning. Have a mind made up mentality. My mind's made up. Hurt no one in the process, right? Do everything that is right and nothing that is wrong. But make your mind up, make your final decision, and don't second guess yourself, because this is your life process, right? This is your life. That is the goal line, I'm going there. Well, I thought we would take a look at the world famous Jeff Beck. Jeff Beck played for the Yardbirds, as did Eric Clapton, as did Jimmy Page. Jimmy Page of Led Zeppelin, Eric Clapton of Cream, you remember those guys, and Jeff Beck. Did you know that Jeff Beck, his singer, was Rod Stewart? Without Jeff Beck, you probably wouldn't know who Rod Stewart was. Interesting.
To me, I wonder, do you think you said anyone like Jeff Beck or Eric Clapton? I said, I wouldn't want to play on an Aussie album. I was absolutely floored when they agreed. And what they played was just mind-blowing.
How did you feel when you heard their guitar contributions for the first time?
I was blown away. I kept playing it and playing it and playing it, going, I can't believe it.
Though they were technically brilliant, their one hit was a cover of Stevie Wonder's track, Superstition, and they parted ways in 1974. Jeff Beck's first solo album, Blow by Blow, was released in March 1975. This record exhibited the guitarist's mastery of the jazz rock genre and was his most commercially successful album. Beatles producer George Martin served as Beck's producer and arranger on the record. After touring in support of the album, he returned to studio to record Wired in 1976. He was joined by keyboardist Jan Hammer, who was a key influence on the album's sound. He was also instrumental on Beck's next album, 1980's There and Back.
It's funny how you look back, it's like an old photo album where you think, oh, sorry about the hair, you know. The Jan stuff still stands up head and shoulders, I think. Just his ears, you know, are so incredible, and his technique. I lost George Martin along the way in the quest to try to find a more aggressive spin on the type of music that I was influenced by, which was Mahavishnu Orchestra, John McLaughlin, and all those great players. What I wanted to do was join up with Jan and try to make a more, slightly more accessible version of that, really. I say accessible, I mean that I was incapable of doing what John did, you know. So it was a watered-down version, but I did have fun doing that.
By the time the early 80s rolled around, Beck began performing in a number of benefit concerts and even played with other former Yardbird Eric Clapton and longtime friend Jimmy Page. Throughout the 1990s and into the new millennium, Beck continued to collaborate with other artists.
Nothing happened, and then I was all of a sudden on 15 other people's albums.
Thank you.
sitting around with Tal and Vinny listening to some McLaughlin stuff, because I still feel drawn to him, John, you know, because of the music he's given us, you know, just spiritually uplifting, astonishing technique, and still has earthiness to it, and Breath Eternal, that riff at the beginning, I still can't get that right, you know. All through rehearsals I'll be getting it wrong, and then the nerves kick in, and then you somehow, by a miracle, you pull it off.
Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Stevie Wonder.
Yeah, I cover that when I heard Syreeta Wright's album, which was Stevie's girl or wife or something. And when I heard that, I thought, I'm going to have a go at that. Immediately I picked out the melody and I thought, this is too good, you know. And Stevie heard it and he rang me up even and said, I really love what you did with that song. That song was actually, the tune and the whole composition was written by Tony. And I put a reggae rhythm under it because I didn't really care for the style of the rhythm that he had. And Tony, he was quite upset until he heard it the next day, and he said, you know what, it sounds pretty good. So had he not liked it, I would have changed it, put it back, or not done the song, but took the best bits of Pork Pie, the intro with the chords, and then went into the melody of Brush With The Blues. So you got two for the price of one there, mate. That's another Hymus composition. I didn't really think about it, I just thought, that's gone. I think Tony one day sent me a cassette of it, and it was so ripping. It was somewhere in Japan, Osaka somewhere. And I was so amazed about the intensity and the precision that I played it to Vinny and Tal, and they went, let's do it. I went, oh no, please, you know. I don't know if I can pull that off. So we rehearsed it, and the results are there, you know. I wrote that. That's my, all those are my riffs. And I wanted to, along with Leif Maces, who was amazing, he actually got the sound on that record, which I think still sounds really good.
Fun facts. I was just right there talking to him, and you see how the water is now full? I was almost getting trapped in the middle of the ocean, right? See how the water filled in right there? It goes so fast that you could still be on that island. Right, a little there, and you'll be in 9 feet of water in no time. So I caught myself. And then if I didn't cross over fast enough, that would have been 9 feet of water in no time, man. Wow, I lucked out. I made it through. See this one over here, it's going right out there, right across here, and then the island will be all water. And Like, it doesn't even take 5 minutes. Gotta be careful. Anyway, glad you could show up today. Glad you could come see me. Always like to take you for a walk on the beach and or in the woods or wherever I'm at. And hope to see you here again next time here at the Guitar Temple.
I don't give a fuck what you say. Yeah, I'ma do shit my way. So you can go kick rocks, I'ma stack bricks up, build what I want to make. Yo, I got a lot of shit to say, so I'ma do this every day. I'll be writing things until I'm fucking buried in my grave. 6 feet deep under, but my body won't decay. Cause my messages are timeless, so they'll put them on display. Oh yeah, I rap with a certainty, I have a sense of urgency. A message for eternity, for everyone internally. I had some people burning me, but now they fucking learn to see. I ain't the one to fuck with, now they looking nervously. And I don't really care what you think of me respectfully. You can kick rocks if you think you're fucking better, see. I will outwork you, turn you to an enemy. Hurt you so bad that you're gonna need some therapy. I got the motherfucking recipe. I've been cooking up hits, I'ma leave a legacy. You'll be looking small when you're standing right next to me. I'm 5'10", bitch, but I'm 10 feet next to me.
Cause I don't give a fuck what you say. Yeah, I'ma do shit my way. So you can go kick rocks, I'ma stack bricks up, build what I want to make. Cause I don't give a fuck what you say. Yeah, I'ma do shit my way. So you can go kick rocks, I'ma stack bricks up, build what I want.